One thing I like to talk to parents about is how they're communicating with their kids. A lot of times when we are trying to parent or discipline our kids, they just kind of perceive that discipline as being talked down to, being told no and don't. They hear those words all the time. Maybe they feel like they're being yelled at. So one of the approaches that you can use is more about helping them just know what things are for. So for example, if a child is coloring on the wall, you might say, the wall is not for coloring on, but you can color on this piece of paper, instead of saying, no, don't color on that wall. Or if a kid is standing in a chair, you might say, the chair is not for standing in, but you can sit in it. Just like in any relationships that we have, the more that the other person feels heard or understood, the more likely we're able to kind of do what they're wanting us to do, or that we feel a part of that relationship. A lot of times in parent-child relationships, we feel like it's always one person telling the other person what to do. And so sometimes when we ask kids, how do they perceive their parents? You know, sometimes they may create these drawings that you'd be surprised about, you know, that they perceive these parents kind of just hovering over them, maybe talking down to them, always telling them no, telling them don't. So if they feel heard and seen by their parent, then they're more likely to feel like they're going to do what you're asking them to do. They feel more connected. They feel like that they're a part of this relationship versus it just being top down and being talked down to. So it's really important to maintain that communication and use some of those examples that we talked about in order to strengthen that relationship and for them to feel heard and seen.